Hey Garage Squad, my name is Bob Gray, and this is my submission video. I'd like to present to you my 1956 Chevy Bel Air. This car is super special to me, and it took me a long, long time to reacquire. It was originally created by my dad, the original Bob Gray, when I was about probably 5 years old. He pulled in two wrecks and built, took them together and built his own, and it was a drag car. He drag raced with it, legally and maybe some illegally, out on the back roads of southeastern Kentucky, where I'm from. Dad was a bit of an outlaw. He, back in the 80s, he bootlegged to the coal miners, and some people loved him, some people didn't, and so either the car was famous or infamous, depending on who you talk to. I always like to say he didn't do anybody wrong that he didn't like. But the point is, though, I'll show you how much he loved and took care of this car. This is what it originally used to look like. But Dad used to build a lot of cars in racing. And he'd always, they were always going and coming, and I used to get upset about it as a little kid because I just loved race cars instead of muscle cars. And he promised me this car when I got 16 he was going to get to me. And unfortunately, my dad passed away when I was 15 years old, so about almost 30 years ago, within the next couple of months. And my grandparents then raised me. Not too long after he passed, someone robbed our savings, and they had to sell the car to make ends meet. And I did not see this car for a long, long time, and I had been was very incredibly heartbroken, and I was very obsessive about trying to track this car down one day. And I learned as I got older that an old classmate of my dad's is who bought it, and he basically used it to help fix his 55 Chevy. He took Dad's 427 out of this and put in his 55, put his 350 in this one, catalyzed it for parts and things, and let it sit outside, and as you can see, he kind of hasn't held up the time because he didn't do a very good job taking care of it. And I tried to get the gentleman to sell it to me, and he was pretty intent on keeping it. Years and years went by. I found out that the gentleman had passed away, and so I started to search for the car, and I got on Facebook, and I called people, and I talked to old classmates and people I hadn't spoke to in years and years. And eventually, I had a man call me out of the blue, and he had the car, and he offered to sell it to me. And he told me he knew my dad, and he was more than happy to sell me this car back. Apparently, he acquired it. The mother and the gentleman that owned it before had sold it to him after that man had passed. So I have the car now. Kids love it. They pretty much think of it as the original Batmobile. Fortunately, it's not in the best condition. The guy started to try to restore a little bit. It's got a little bit of chrome and things, but it's got a lot of work needs done to it. It's not running at the moment. And unfortunately, I'm not the mechanic my father was, and I don't really have the funds or the time to kind of get it to where I want it to be. And I'll tell you how much, how happy we were at least to get it. But this is a picture of me and my oldest when we first got the car. And he's 5 now, so he was a little bit younger then. But I don't know how much help you all can do or if you're able. But obviously, how obsessed I was about trying to get this car back. I have a toy one I bought, to put on my shelf, to remind me this is what I'd like to get someday. My dream would be to get it modernized and looking, just so I could have it, safe to run to drive my boys in like my dad used to do for me, and be able to go out to dinner, on the weekends with my wife, and have it, just a family heirloom that I could pass down to my sons when they get older. Modernize it or something. I don't know what y'all can or will do or can do, but it would mean the world to me to have this old car up and running again after it took me 20 years to track down the time. Anyways, again, my name's Bob Gray, and this is from down in Kentucky, and I hope to hear from y'all.
Now,
okay, ready?
Go! 1, 2, 3, go!
Go, Garage Squad! Save the Batmobile!
That was good.
All right, that was good.